how do we match the skills requirements of businesses with those students, with those kids, with those students we want to get into work. There's more than that. I see more slides, more information, more data. By little of action, that's not criticism of you in terms of the performances, because it's good in the sense of it paints the picture. But I'm just less convinced that we've got our head around this. You know, when I look at the super board and when I see that the jobs that are going to be created, and I'm asking myself the question, where are the kids with all the district strain? How are we motivating people to take advantage of those opportunities? And those things aren't being addressed, whether it's in the creative digital sector, the new technologies, the things that we know are going to happen as the city needs and develops. There's nothing in, there's nothing that connects that. That's a real concern for me. So, I welcome the report in the sense of its context of setting out the failings, but I'd like to see a lot more action about the rest of the failings, and that includes motivating new people. In a nutshell, I'm sick and tired of going to consumers and talking to the unions and the attendants when asked the question, what is it you aspire to be, what is it you want to be? They say, want to go into sports, without no knowledge of what is and what is available in terms of opportunities. We've got to address that. Okay, I accept the fact that we've done presentations and we've done things in St. Helens, we did stuff with the IFB. They're great, but then we've got to think of business to be a little bit more involved in this as well, to get out and motivate you, to get out and talk to know what the opportunities are. But as I said, I think the TVO gives us an opportunity with potentially new apprenticeship in front of them with how we control some of what's happening. We've just got to get a lot better than what we are. I'm sorry to be negative in that regard, but I don't think we're anywhere near being where we should be.
Okay, any other points? Andy?
Just in on Joe's point, it's much easier if we do need to move this forward in that sense. Left board because it's going to be come up with recommendations from the left board. Where we all fit together and how we drive that forward. So still an anecdote to that, I've asked our speaker to protect exactly and the guy that was shown down talks to them slowly about taking the guy to school children out to teach him with the children center outside. If you don't listen to what's going on, it's university, you will pay for it.
Some of them are on 50 plus thousand
pounds. Terry.
Thanks. Just a contribution from me. I mean, we're all studying high classes, careers advice. I think it's non-existent nowadays, and I think we need to get back to actually what Joe's on about, and whether employers engage more with us to actually get into the schools at lower. But, I mean, primary schools as much as anything, to get kids. I mean, it's a dirty word, engineering, in this country for some reason. Don't know why, but it's we've got a lot of catching up to do. And careers advice is non-existent nowadays in any of our areas, and that's what we've got to get back to. Giving the kids guidance at the right age and the right steps and the pathway to get careers.
Okay, thanks, Terry. Any other points? Okay, so I suspect we will come back to this in the coming kind of weeks and months, particularly in the context of devolution. However, for today, are we content to agree the recommendations on page 15, A and B? Are they agreed? Okay, thanks for that, Sue. Right, that takes us to item 7, at which point I'm going to vacate the chair and ask Barry to take over this item.
Seven, skills capital investment, 1-6 and apprentice strand, 1-2 assessment outcome. So.
£41 million allocated through the growth deal for skills capital funding. actually now progressing. Just as a reminder, there was £2 million allocated to Royal Met College, there's an allocation to Southport College, City Liverpool College, and to Hugh Baird College. In terms of Royal Met, they had a broad capital programme operating just prior to this point, and they're now in the process of refurbishing the 12 key sites. So you can see there the maps and plans are in place, and they're just about to go out to tender on the detail of that. So that one is very much in the pipeline. In terms of Southport College, this one is progressed further. Part of this was to do some work to the kitchens and to get the new standards required that are now part of the syllabus. So they've done that. So there's work around the motor vehicle workshop and some work around engineering expansion, and they're likely that the work will be starting pretty soon on that one. City of Liverpool College, in terms of their work, they've appointed a project team, and they will be starting the procurement phase quite quickly on that. And Hubert is in a similar position with their application. In terms of for today, in the appendix to the report, you've got details of the four applications and the assessments of these that have been done by the investment panel. And basically, Riverside College, Maritime Engineering College Northwest, North Liverpool Regeneration and a joint proposal from St Helens College and Muslim Community College. These have all been assessed by the panel, and the recommendation to provide all those today is that these will be approved.
Thank you very much for that, Sue. Any other questions or comments?
What comments in terms of the biggest capital investment? Consistent that we use the same criteria that we use in order to make sure local labour and local supply is used in the construction of cars and for any resource supply, making sure that that happens.
So that takes us on to our final item today, which is item 8, interim management arrangements. Angela, could you introduce this, please?
Thank you, Chair. All members are aware of the announcement which was made only last week by Transport for the North that David Brown has been appointed its first chief executive. The report before you provides some information in relation to how this affects the combined authority and how it affects Merseytravel. And specifically, it notes that because it's not anticipated that Transport for the North will be a legal entity with statutory status until 2017, there is a need for an organisation with legal status to fulfil the role of employer until this takes place. The Combined Authority is being asked today to accept that Merseytravel will fulfil that role as from the 9th of November, and it's intended that Mr. Brown will take up his new role. There will be no cost to either to the city, to the Combined Authority or to Merseytravel, because costs will be met by the accountable body called Transport for the North, which I understand is the Sheffield City Region Combined Authority. As you expect, there are other more detailed arrangements related to the employment relationship, which are currently being worked through, and will need to be sorted before the 9th of November when Mr. Brown takes up his role. On that basis, I am asking the Combined Authority for a delegation to be given to me as Managing Officer in consultation with the Chair of the Combined Authority to approve those arrangements. Members will be particularly concerned about the impact of the recent appointment on the City Region's transport priorities and what we want to be assured that those can be minimised. It is recommended that the Deputy Chief Executive of Merseytravel is appointed as its Interim Director until further decision by the Combined Authority. The Interim Director will take the necessary steps to increase capacity to cover his existing duties. Finally, following Mr. Brown taking up his new role on the 9th of November, there will be a need for the Combined Authority to appoint a new head of paid service. It's intended to bring a report on the matter to the next meeting, but decision by the Combined Authority. There will be a small gap between when Mr. Brown takes up his role on the 9th and the next meeting of the Combined Authority on the 20th of November. But a report will be brought to that meeting with the intention that the Combined Authority will appoint a new head of paid service. Thank you.
Thanks, Angela. Okay, so just to kind of emphasise the point Angela makes, you know, these are interim arrangements. Can I just ask your members to contact with this, Joe?
Can I just ask for clarification off on this instance of competency and the length of time? You talk about the 2 years being that you've been asking the Combined Authority to act as if you actually sort of manage it, that's kind of thing. So in effect, where does that leave us in terms of replacing the thing?
That is a matter to be worked through. The Combined Authority will host the arrangements of an employer of Mr. Brown for a 2 year period. That's not what we're saying in terms of the outcome of the Chief Executive of Merseytravel. You can, the Combined Authority is able to appoint a new Chief Executive of Merseytravel within that 2 year period. What that period will be is not to be worked through now.
So, why haven't we agreed to a 2 year period?
I think the Transport for the North will not become a statutory body as anticipated until 2017. So Transport for the North is not able to act as an employer for its chief executive. So a legal entity such as Merseytravel will need to host.
Because this is the police, I don't necessarily discuss the public. Can I ask that we have a look at that before in the sense that police got to
I
appropriate to sort of sign up to that. So I think we need some conversation.
Yeah, you're right. I think all that we're being asked to do today is kind of note David's appointments, agree that Frank Rogers comes in as an interim Director General Chief Exec. In terms of the longer term arrangements beyond that, I think that's we'll have further report back pending further discussions.
Well,
I think that's what we're being asked to do.
Angela read that was a section that said that we agreed to the period, and that's why I received the clarification first from it. What I'm absolutely saying is that I'm not comfortable with the period to that arrangement.
Do you want to just reply to that specifically, Angela?
Yeah, I mean, in section 3.3 of the report, it does say that it's not anticipated that transport will not be a statutory body until 2017. And until such time as it has statutory status, it's proposed that Merseytravel will host the chief executive. It isn't, we're not saying that until such time as the employment is transferred, transport for the north, the command authority cannot appoint a new chief executive of Merseytravel. That is something that's being worked through. And that is the reason that the request has been made for a delegation in consultation with Cllr to be able to deal with those issues before Mr. Brown has due to commence his new role on the 9th of November.
Chair.
Chair, that's as clear as the reality is I've made my position clear that I'm happy for David to take this from the post. What I'm not happy is for this development policy in moving forward to find a replacement, if that's so required, I want that explicitly agreed before I say, that's why. That's what I'm happy with. You know, I've spent a whole lot of things, but I just want that. It's been ambiguous to me, and what he says he doesn't give me a great deal of comfort, and I'll see it right.
Barrie, you wanted to.
Yeah, no, it's just a question in terms of risk as well, I suppose, in some ways, that in terms of if we're hosting David's employment before the official transfer to TFN, and then we were to move on and appoint a new director as well, does that leave us liable and expose us to a risk also?
No, we would have an agreement with Sheffield Command Authority, and we'd make sure that they took the risk in relation to them.
Chair, do you want to come in?
Chair, just in the interest of obviously trying to be helpful on this, there was several conversations that I've been party to with Councillor Robinson, who's obviously not able to be here today.
He's getting married today.
Which is a much more sensible thing to do than to go to the authority, I would suggest. But but I suspect that that time scale issue has been lost a little bit in translation since Emma originally did the paperwork. It was obviously several days in advance of this particular meeting, because my own understanding wasn't quite consistent with that 2-year period issue. It was being spoken about at one time, but I thought that I'd moved on in translation. But of course, I don't know the full detail of that, because Councillor Robinson does, and he's not here, and I'm not going to interrupt his. There's other pressing commitments today. So maybe taking the Mayor's concerns and other members' concerns to one side, if we clarify that maybe through a conversation with David outside of the meeting about what his understanding is, I would suggest that in the interests of trying to move the issue forward, that we've got to come back with a proposal on the rest of the issue anyway, that unless there's a deal-breaker issue from David's point of view or elsewhere in the system that I'm not aware of, we can tidy up the exact detail of how that mechanism may or may not work, and whether the timescale is that period of time or not, if you like.
Angela, do you want to sum up on this? Just so everybody's clear.
As I explained, my understanding is that the Merseytravel will host the chief executive until the time Transport for the North is a statutory body and the appointment will transfer. In the meantime, if the combined authority wishes to appoint a chief executive, the combined authority would be entitled to do so. That needs to be, as Jess indicated, tied up in the arrangements that are made with Mr. Brown.
I would be interested to know what Transport for the North think about this. Do they think they have David on call for 2 years? And what I hear is that that may be a presumption. And that seems to be the other side of the coin. So I don't think. Yeah, the question is, what is their expectation? What is the expectation for Transport for the North and how that might work? If that was a 2 year expectation, it seems to be that may not be what we all think.
Thanks, yeah. I think the clearest position here is that David Brown is being taken on by Transport for the North for that period of time and hopefully beyond in his own career interests and obviously the interests of Transport for the North. That's not an issue. The issue that's causing the confusion is not David leaving and taking on that role, it's the status of the 2 year period that Angela's referring to. And where that leaves David in employment terms, and that's the bit that needs to clarify, because the conversations that I was alluding to were for a shorter period around that certainty and where it leaves Merseytravel and all the issues locally here, as opposed to Transport for the North. In answer to Robert's point, it is very clear that he is going to be moving to do Transport for the North 100% of his time for that 2 year period and beyond. It's in the first part of the summary that Angela gave a second ago that just need to clarify that issue. I think it's the second part.
Joey, are you content to agree these recommendations as an interim pending clarification around specifically the point you raised?
Yes, because I'm not particularly interested in what's in the benefits of interest of Transport for the North. That's for Transport for the North. I'm interested in what's in the best interest of this particular combined authority, and I'm not prepared to accept that we are fettered. Of course, however, we're not. And I'm happy to see that in a better legal clause that points out that we brought back to us at a later date.
Yeah, okay. Can we agree with that then? Yeah, is that agreed?
Yeah.
Okay, thanks very much. Okay, so I've not been informed of any urgent items of business, so can I thank everybody for their attendance today? And just remind you, the next scheduled meeting of the Combined Authority will be at 11 a.m. on Friday, the 20th of November, and I declare the meeting closed. Thank you for your attendance. Thank you.